Hello! Today we will be covering the options available to us in the communications menu of iRev, as well as creating a custom stream format. We already have a scale set up, and you will need one as well in order to enable streaming. So if you need more information on setting up scales, please view our video, Setting Up a Scale Using iRev. We are already connected, so we will now proceed to the Systems Parameter tab, and then select Communications. By default, there will be four ports here, but if you have a dual serial expansion card, you will have additional ports that can be configured. We will now proceed to configure serial port 1 as our stream. First, we will verify that our baud rate, data bits, parity, and stop bits are all configured to be what we want them. Since I want a baud rate of 9600, data bits and parity of 8 none, and stop bits of 2, my port is already configured the way I want it. Next, we will enable streaming by going to the Streaming tab. Here we see the stream types available for this port. Legal for trade and industrial are our options for streaming. The other three options, display, keypad, and four keys, are all for when using multiple indicators in a local remote type setup. I will use legal for trade, as it is Rice Lake's most stable stream. After selecting Legal for Trade, the source scale and format parameters both become available for manipulation. Since I wish to stream my scale 2's weight, I will select scale 2 as my source scale number. I will also select custom for my stream format. Now that we have serial port 1 configured to stream out a custom format involving scale 2, we will move on to manipulating the stream. To do this, we go to the left side and select Stream Formatting. Once in Stream Formatting, we will select Stream Editor. Here it shows us that our stream format number 1 that we enabled earlier is available for configuration. We have several streams available to load and use, but for this demonstration, we will be editing the standard string instead. We have three tabs available, with pre-built formats currently selected. We will select the third tab, titled Stream. We can see the default stream now. It consists of a start of text, a character for polarity, a token for weight with 7 digits and a decimal, characters for units, mode, and scale status. The CR and LF at the end are for carriage return and line feed respectively, signaling the end of our string. For this demonstration, we will configure the string by removing the mode character and the units character. We are operating under the assumption that we know our customer does not want to see that they are in gross or net mode, and knows the units they are using. To do this, we will highlight the mode and units tokens, including their surrounding brackets, and press the delete key. We also know that our customer only wants to see the gross weight on the scale, so we will modify our W7 dot to a G7 dot. If you want to see all the available options for weight formatting, press the W7 button, and it will allow you to manipulate the weight token to fit your needs. Once we have completed our customization, we will send this to the indicator. So we go to Communications and select Download Configuration. Once the download window pops up, we will verify that the standard configuration checkbox is checked and then click the Begin button. Once that is complete, we save and exit on the indicator. This has been a demonstration of setting up a serial stream and configuring a custom stream format. Thank you for your time.